may look like snakes, but they're actually fish. They're rarely seen, but they lurk in waters all over the Delaware Basin. They're not attractive, but people around the world love to eat them. They're American eels. American eels are great travelers. Every eel in the Delaware Basin has migrated here from the Sargasso Sea, southwest of Bermuda. After years of living in fresh water, adults will migrate back to the Sargasso to spawn. When they do, eel harvesting begins. The Delaware Valley's eel supply has always exceeded its demand. The area's greatest demand for eels occurs around Christmas. The real market for eels is in Europe, where they're considered a delicacy. An eel that's been spawned in the Sargasso and harvested in the Delaware will more than likely end up on a European table. Most commercial eelers harvest in the bay, where male eels gather before migrating. Bay eelers use underwater traps called pots. Feeding eels, lured by bait, are trapped inside and then hauled in. Eels are most valuable alive. They're kept alive on deck with an aerated live box. Having fed themselves for migration, they'll survive without food all the way to Europe. Perhaps the most interesting eel harvest takes place far up the Delaware between Pennsylvania and New York, where larger females leave their inland lakes and streams and make their spawning run to the sea. Harvesting these fast-moving females has historically been done quite differently, with huge funnel-like traps called eel weirs. One such eel weir, located in the Delaware River above Port Jervis, belongs to Art Conklin.
The terminology is eel weir. We use eel rack. We've always used eel rack. Actually, it's just a rack in the middle of the river. And the eels swim in and they can't swim out. There's always been eel racks on the river. Me and my father, we got into it in the Neversink, and then we just moved to the Delaware. When you work inside all day, it's kind of nice to be out, not hearing the traffic and the planes and just hearing the rumble of the river. The eels are going to follow the natural course of the river, the fastest, swiftest way to get back to the ocean. If you find yourself a spot in the rapids, you build two rock walls 300 feet long with the stones that you pull out of the bottom of the river. Once they come through the walls, they are funneled down to the eel rack. They come over the falls and they're trapped. They swim back down towards the water into the box. There's 2 feet of the box underneath the water. That's enough to keep them alive for us to get up there and clean them out. Early October, eels are triggered by the difference in the water temperature to head back down to the ocean to spawn. They run primarily at night. The best time to actually catch them is really dark, cool nights. When you had 3 days of rain, the water temperature starts dropping. You check that eel rack once a day. The majority of eels that we catch are probably about pound, pound and a half a piece. We net them out in nylon mesh bags. We carry them across the river in a canoe, and we travel 15 miles to hold them boxes, kept in a naturally spring-fed brook. We have a lot of local customers, and they'll buy 50 pounds at a time. They put them in salt brine and smoke them. The eels have already stopped eating. There's no need to feed them. And the eels that we don't use, we'll release them into the brook, and they'll swim back down into the river. It's more of a hobby than it is, you know, trying to earn a living. I plan on doing it every year until it's possible. I hope to teach my kids how to do it. Maybe someday my son will want to do it, if we can keep their river quality up. Thank you.